Hello, and welcome back to Finch, and welcome to another Finch Academy course. In this course, I'm going to teach you how to generate compliant floor plans in Finch. We're going to start with drawing floor plans using our AI Copilot. I'll then show you how to add constraints, add furniture, and then apply these plans in your project using some graph rules to make sure that we are hitting all our compliances and regulations. Let's go ahead and click on our plans icon at the top here. I'm going to come down and make sure we have my library selected. Otherwise, we won't be able to create a plan. Then we're just going to go ahead and hit create plan to bring up our plan studio. So the first thing we see is our bounds. So these are our perimeter of our apartment. And then we also have our square meterage. Now, before we go and adjust the size of our apartment, let's take a little look at the icons that we have highlighted at the top. Here on our right, we have our dimensions. You can turn this on and off with D. Always good to have this on when we're drawing our plans. Then we have our unit and space labels. This is great once we start assigning space types. Turn this on and off with L. Then we have our accessibility bounds. And this is great for when we're working with furniture to see the accessibility bounds around the furniture. And then finally, what I have on here is my graph rule. If you prefer, you can turn these off. These are going to really come in handy once we start placing our furniture in our rooms and setting some constraints. Now, to edit the bounds of our apartment, it's as simple as just double-clicking to come in. Then we can just select any of these and write our new figures here. Now, what we have here is a square apartment, but of course, if you also want to draw L-shaped apartments, it's as simple as coming up and selecting our Draw Bounds tool, Drawing, and then if we want to keep them straight, we just hold Shift in that direction that we want. Let's come up here, here. So if we wanted this, we just go ahead and hit enter. But instead, I'm going to make a square apartment for us. Hit enter to finish. And here we have it. Now, we're actually going to start drawing our plan here. And I always think a great place to start is by hitting T to bring up our door icon to then start with our access to this apartment. I'm going to start with our entrance door here. Make this door a little bit wider. Give this a nice round figure. Great. Now let's start drawing some walls, some rooms. But to do that, let's have some help from our AI Copilot. To ask for the help, we just turn on this little icon here or hit U for suggestions. Now it's as simple as if we draw our walls, let's start with a little space here, another room here, and then another room here. And now what we see is suggestions given to us. So if we just go ahead and click on these, it's going to assign this as a bathroom. And now watch if we draw some other walls here. It's going to give us a suggestion for a bedroom, so let's use this. Then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use my separators now because I want to keep this as an open plan space. And go ahead and draw one separator here, and another one here, and another one here. And it's actually now predicting exactly how I want my layout here. So I want my living space here, dining area here, and my kitchen here. And it's seeing that this space kind of in between them all is a hallway. And perfect, let's have some storage. And look at that. See how quickly we've just laid out our plan and assigned our rooms. So that's our walls and our space type set up. So for the final part of this tutorial, let's just go ahead and add all of our interior doors. Once again, we hit T to bring up our door shortcut. Let's have one door to the bedroom here. Let's have a door to the bathroom here. Let's go ahead and choose from our drop-down option of doors to these kind of sliding doors here for our storage space. In the next tutorial, we're going to cover adding furniture, looking at accessibility bounds, and setting constraints in our plans. Thank you.